Today, I had a request for the Photoshop Adobe Exchange. Now, it's changed a little bit in Photoshop CS6, and it's kind of neat. The classic Exchange still works very, very well, and you can still find all your brushes and everything. But today, we're going to talk about this window. Is it called the extension for the Adobe Exchange? So we're going to open up a new document. I'm just going to follow along with one I have. Now we have this window, and you're all should be all familiar with all the things that we can play with in here. Now there's this Adobe Exchange, and you'll also notice that Cooler and Mini Bridge are also in there. So you click on the Adobe Exchange. And if you don't have Cooler, you might be able to find it in the Adobe Exchange. So what we're going to do today is the watermark. And you just type in watermark and hit enter. And you come up with this Adobe watermark by Russell Brown. You'll click on it and install it, and then when you install it, it's going to ask you, do you want to watch the tutorial by Russell Brown on how to use it? I highly recommend doing that because it goes into far more detail than I will here. So you click on it and install it, and since I already have it installed, what it's going to ask you to do is it's going to tell you that you need to turn off Photoshop and restart it so that your plugins work. You're going to select your source for your watermark, and I have all of my watermarks stored in a folder called Watermarks, and I can change out from my company watermark to my personal logo watermark, or you can just use text and say copyright John Doe 2013. And you can also set the text color and what font and what size you want it to be at. The next thing you're going to do is it's going to ask you, where do you want me to store this file after I've put this watermark on it? So you will go in and you'll tell it select the folder and tell it where to go. And I tell it to use the open images, that way I don't forget which one I'm working on if I have more than one open. It is a good idea to be only working on one image at a time, otherwise it creates multiple copies of your JPEG images with your watermark. If you're working on two or three images, you're going to get two or three brand new images with watermarks on them. Then you're going to tell it where you want it. Now for me, it's the lower right, but you can do center right, lower left, upper left. You can center it on the bottom. You can center it right in the middle of your picture if that's where you want it to be. It's all up to you and what you need it to do. The next step is to set it for how big you want it. What size of JPEG do you want? Do you want to save it as a standard JPEG image, which is in this case 300 pixels per inch, PPI, and I want high quality, so I type in the 12 there. Now if you save it for a JPEG for the web, it's going to give you the automatic 72 pixels per inch. Now I turn on the Smart Sharpen and the sharpen options because sometimes I want to add a little bit of more detail to my images, especially if I'm working in fractals. And then when you're done, you just close it down. And to show you how it works, we're going to place an image. And since I have all these fractal images that I've been generating, that one looks nice. We'll play with it for a second. Because my image is actually smaller than my workspace, I'm going to stretch it out a little bit. I'm going to double click on my background layer because I don't really need it, and I'm going to delete it. And then, since I'm selected here, I'm going to go in and I'm going to go to Filter and Render, and then to Lighting Effects. And because there's so much green in here, I want to add a lighting effect of green, and I want to take it down. I also want to change the intensity of the light and make it quite a bit darker. It doesn't really need to be that bright because it's going to change when I do the JPEG save on it. Now we hit OK. And it takes you back to your original screen. Now I'm going to save it. And I believe this one was called 1W, or is it 2W? We'll just call it 2W. And click OK. Now you got to wait for it to finish saving. And as soon as that save image countdown is gone, you go over here, open up your watermark, and you hit Run. You see how it changes the screen? And it's also changed the way my image looked from the way I did it in the original PSD file. That's because of those smart sharpen options. And I click OK. Now I want to see how it looks after I've got my watermark on it. And since I know it's going to go back to my Facebook headers page or folder, I'm going to click on that one and I'm going to open it up. Now I know I made this image 8.5 by 11 when I started, or 11 by 8.5. But because it's a JPEG now, it's quite a bit smaller. So if I want to go into DeviantArt and make it big enough to sell as a print, I go to image size and I want to make it 40 inches wide by 30 inches wide, because that's the biggest I want to sell this print as. You can constrain your portions if you'd like. Now I'm going to take it back down to zero, or do command zero, so I can see the whole picture. And there you have it. Now I'm going to hit save again so that I can save that image so that I can upload it to DeviantArt or anywhere else I want it to go. So thanks for watching, and if you have any other questions, check out more on the Adobe Exchange in the Adobe sites. You can contact me at www.gadgetgeekdesigns.com or leave me a message in the comments. Thanks for watching.